Good morning, students. In the last class, we have completed the lesson. The Dear Departed Part 2, and we have completed the lesson, grammar, vocabulary, writing skills, and other activities from the lesson. So, today we are moving to the new lesson from C Reading, and the name of the lesson is The Brave Potter. If you see in your textbook, The Brave Potter, Margaret Sage has chosen a very well-known Indian folk tale for retelling in English. Children and adults alike are fond of folk tales, which are often amusing and sometimes instructive. So, the story is a folk tale. So, if you see the story, it was dark. Thick black clouds covered the evening sky. The thunder roared and the strong wind shook the branches and leaves of the trees in the forest. Pit, pat, pit, drops of rain fell. Then the lightning flashed and split the black sky with its blinding light. Soon it was raining heavily. So, the story is, if you see the first paragraph, they are explaining that it was dark and thick black clouds were covered the evening sky, and the thunder roared and the strong wind shook the branches and leaves of the trees in the forest. So, this story is in the forest in the evening, and what they are saying is the thunder means during rain we can see the sounds from the sky, isn't it? So, the same way the thunder roared and the strong winds shook the branches and leaves of the trees in the forest. And pit, pat, pit means in that rhythm drops of rain fell. Then the lightning flashed and split the black sky with its blinding light, means very bright light. Soon it was raining heavily. An old tiger ran through the rain looking for shelter. He was wet and cold and his cave was far away. While hurrying to his shelter, he saw an old hut. With a sign of relief, the tiger crawled under the thatched roof and lay down by the door. Except for the sound of the rain, all was quiet. Before he could nod off, however, he heard something heavy being dragged inside the hut. This was followed by the voice of a woman. So, the old tiger ran through the rain looking for shelter, means it came very far in search of food, isn't it? So it was searching for a shelter in the rain as it was wet and cold, and also the cave of the tiger was far away. So while hurrying to his shelter, means while hurrying to his cave, he saw an old hut. With a sign of relief, the tiger crawled under the thatched roof. Thatched means covered with dried straw, and lay down by the door. Except for the sound of the rain, all was quiet. Means only the sound of the rain can be heard. Before he could nod off, means fall asleep. However, he heard something heavy being dragged. Where inside the hut, he heard something heavy has been dragged inside the hut. And along with the sound, he heard a voice of a woman. "Oh, how tremble this leak is," she complained. "How terrible. I would rather meet a tiger in the forest than have this leak in my house. So what that lady is telling is how terrible this leak is, means that much horribly the leakage was there in the hut. So what she is telling that how terrible this leak is. I would rather meet a tiger in the forest than having this leak in my house. So what she feel is going in front of a tiger is better when compared to this heavy leak in the hut. A leak, the tiger thought. What is a leak? It must be very dangerous and strong, or the woman would not be more frightened of the leak than of me. Am I not rightly called the king of the forest? Aren't they all afraid of me? I wonder what a leak looks like. So by listening the words of the woman, the tiger started thinking, what is a leak? And it is thinking that it must be very dangerous and strong, or the woman would not be afraid, means frightened of the leak than of me. So what that tiger is thinking, that leak might be, what is that leak? And that leak might be dangerous and strong, because the woman is more frightened to that leak when compared to me. And it is thinking that it is thinking that it is not a right king of the forest. And it is thinking that are the people not afraid to me? And it wonder what a leak looks like, means the tiger want to know what the leak actually is. Soon afterwards, the tired tiger fell asleep. He was suddenly awakened by an angry voice shouting in his ear. He felt heavy blows fall upon his head and shoulders. So by thinking all those things, it felt asleep and suddenly awaked. Who? The tiger awaked by an angry voice shouting in his ears and a heavy blow upon his head and his shoulders. "You horrible beast," a voice screamed angrily. "How dare you run away? How dare you make me walk about in the middle of the night trying to find you? Be careful. One of these days I will kill you. Now go home." So what did it heard? It heard that, "You horrible beast." A voice screamed angrily. "And how dare you run away? How dare you make me walk in the middle of the night trying to find you? And be careful, one of these days I will kill you. Now go home." So that tiger heard all these sounds. So the old tiger shivered by listening all these words. The old tiger shivered. "This must be the leak. Who has come out of the hut? I'd better do as he says or he will kill me." So the old tiger, it was shivering with fear, and it thought it might be the leak who has come out of the hut. And the tiger thought it would be better to do as he says, otherwise he will kill me. So like that the tiger is thinking. So the tiger allowed himself to be bound around the neck with a thick rope. The mysterious creature then climbed onto the tiger's back and pulled at the rope. "Come on." So the tiger was afraid that it might kill him, and it followed, means it allowed himself to be bound around the neck, means normally we tie a rope to cattle, isn't it? In the same way they have bound around the neck with a thick rope, and a mysterious creature then climbed onto the tiger's back and pulled at the rope. "Come on." If you see here in the image also, you can see how they have tied round the neck of the tiger and how he has climbed on it. Head for home, shouted the voice. The tiger felt a sharp kick on his side. The tiger was terrified. He ran through the dark forest. The creature pulled hard on the rope to tell him which way to go. At the same time, it scolded, crushed, and kicked the poor tiger. Soon they stopped in front of a small hut on the edge of the thick forest. The creature climbed down from the tiger's back and bound him with an iron chain to a nearby tree. Then he went inside the hut. The tiger could not free himself from the chain, so he had to spend a miserable night under the tree. Who was this creature? Who was able to capture such a large and dangerous tiger? Let's find out. So, as that creature climbed on the back of the tiger and asked the tiger to head for home, means to go to home, and the tiger felt a sharp kick on his side, and the tiger was terrified and he ran through the dark forest, and that creature who was sitting on the tiger pulled hard on the rope and tell him the way the tiger has to go. At the same time, that creature has scolded, crushed, and kicked the poor tiger. Soon they stopped in front of a small hut on the edge of the forest, and the creature climbed down from the tiger's back and bound him with an iron chain. Means he tied the tiger with the iron chain to a nearby tree. Then he went inside the hut. The tiger could not free himself from the chain, so he had to spend a miserable night under the tree. Who was this creature? Who was able to capture such a large and dangerous tiger? Let's find out. On the afternoon of that day, a potter had arrived home after a hard day's work. He was tired and thirsty. He had asked his wife for some palm wine. The more he drank, the better he felt. When he had drunk all the wine, he was no longer felt tired. When the storm began, the potter suddenly remembered that he had left his donkey tied under a tree. He rushed out of his hut to take the animal into the stable. You can imagine his anger when he discovered that donkey was not there anymore. The only thing left was its chain. So, one afternoon, actually what happened is, one afternoon, a potter had arrived his home after a hard day's work, and he was tired and thirsty, and he asked his wife for some palm wine. The more he drank, he felt more better, and he had drunk all the wine and no longer felt tired. And when the storm began, the potter suddenly remembered that he has tied his donkey under a tree, and he rushed out of his hut to take the animal into the stable. Then when he went there, he could not find his donkey, but he can find only the chain. So we can imagine how angry he might be. "My stupid donkey must have run off into the forest," he grumbled. "When I catch him, I will give him a good beating." So that man is thinking that my stupid donkey must have run off into the forest, and when I catch him, I will give him a good beating. So he is thinking like that. The potter walked through the wet forest. When it became dark, he often stumbled over roots and fallen branches. With each step, the potter felt angrier and angrier with his donkey. So the potter walked through the wet forest in search of his donkey. When it became dark, he often stumbled over roots and fallen branches. With each step, the potter felt very angry and angry with his donkey, because in that dark, that donkey has made him to go into that dark and thick forest, isn't it? So he is becoming very angry on that donkey. When I catch him, I will tie him under the tree all night, he murmured to himself. Hours later, the potter reached the old woman's hut. There he saw an animal sleeping in front of the door. So, thinking like that, he was thinking that I will catch him, and when I'll catch him, I will tie him under the tree whole night. Means he don't want to keep him in the stable. Instead, he want to tie it under the tree whole night. So murmured himself. Murmured means spoke something that cannot be heard. Means he's talking to himself. So hours later, that potter has reached the old woman's hut. There he saw an animal sleeping in front of the door. There he is, he shouted. There he is, the stupid animal. So in that dark, he can't understand what it is. Is it a donkey or a tiger? He thought it is a donkey, and he's telling there it is, and he's telling that the stupid animal. He's telling to that tiger, thinking it is a donkey. The drunken potter did not notice the difference between the donkey and the tiger. He kicked and beat the sleeping tiger. He then jumped onto the frightened animal's back, rode it home, and then tied it up with the iron chain. So as the potter is drunk, he did not notice the difference between a donkey and a tiger, and he kicked and he beat that sleeping tiger, and then he jumped onto that frightened animal's back. And he rode it home, means he took it home, and then he tied it up with a chain, with the iron chain, to a tree. Next morning, the villagers who passed the potter's house looked in amazement at the tiger tied to the tree. Soon the news spread throughout the village that the potter had caught a tiger and tied it to a tree in his yard. All the villagers praised his courage. They also thanked him because the tiger had eaten many of their goats and buffaloes. They had tried to catch him for many years but had failed. Of course, the potter said that he had done nothing for the sort. He said that he had only brought his donkey home. He did not understand how a donkey could change into a tiger. When he saw the tiger, he fainted. So as he tied that tiger in front of his home to a tree, next morning all the villagers who passed in front of the potter's house looked in amazement. Means because the tiger is tied to a tree in front of the potter's house. So by everyone was looking at the tiger in amazement, and soon the news has spread throughout the village, and the potter had caught. What the news has spread? The news has spread that the potter had caught a tiger and he tied it to a tree in his yard, and all the villagers praised his courage, and they all thanked him because the tiger had eaten many of their goats and buffaloes, and they had tried to catch him for many years but had failed. So everyone, all the villagers were praising the potter for catching the tiger, as the tiger was eating their goats and buffaloes. Of course, the potter said that he had done nothing of the sort. So the potter is telling that I have did nothing. He was telling that he had only brought his donkey home. He did not understand how a donkey could change into a tiger. And when he saw the tiger, he fainted. Nobody, however, believed the potter's story. The villagers even praised him for being modest. Soon the potter became famous. Everybody who met him called him the brave potter. The simple potter himself never understood why. So everyone believed the potter's story, and nobody, however, believed the potter's story. So the villagers were praised as he was telling that he just tied a donkey but not the tiger. So no one has believed that. And the villagers praised him for being modest, and the potter became very famous. And everybody who met him called that potter as the brave potter. And the simple potter himself never understood why. So this is the story, and we'll be completing the remaining part of the story in the next section. Thank you. Have a good day.